This is S. Selvi, Head Department of English, JJ College of Arts and Science, Pudukottai, presenting A.D. Hope's poem, Australia. Introduction to the author, A.D. Hope. Alex Derwent Hope was an Australian poet and essayist known for his satirical slant. He was born on 21st July 1907 in Cooma, Australia. The Australian poet A.D. Hope is best known for his elegies and satires. He began publishing poems when he was 14 years old. He taught at various Australian universities, including Sydney Teachers College and Melbourne University, until his retirement in 1972. Though traditional in form, his poetry is thoroughly modern. Hope also wrote religious and metaphysical poems as well as erotic verse. His first book of poems, The Wandering Islands, appeared in 1955 and was followed by several volumes of new poems and of collected poems. He also wrote essays and criticism, including A Midsummer Eve's Dream in the year 1970, The Cave and the Spring in the year 1965, and Native Companions in the year 1974. He was made a member of the Order of the British Empire in 1972 and a Companion of the Order of Australia in 1981. He passed away on 13th July 2000 in Canberra, Australia. He was referred to in an American journal as the 20th century's greatest 18th century poet. The poem Australia. A nation of trees, drab green and desolate grey, in the field uniform of modern wars, darkens her hills, those endless outstretched paths of Sphinx demolished or stone line worn away. They call her a young country, but they lie. She is the last of lands, the emptiest, a woman beyond her change of life, a breast still tender, but within the womb is dry. Without songs, architecture, history, the emotions and superstitions of younger lands, her rivers of water drown among inland sands, the river of her immense stupidity. Floods her monotonous stripes from Cairns to Perth. In them at last the ultimate men arrive, whose boast is not we live, but we survive, a type who will inhabit the dying earth, and her five cities like five teeming sows, each drains her a vast parasite robber state, where second-hand Europeans pullulate timidly on the edge of alien shores. Yet there are some like me turned gladly home from the lush jungle of modern thought to find the Arabian desert of the human mind, hoping if still from the deserts the prophets come, such savage and scarlet as no green hills dare, springs in that waste some spirit which escapes the learned doubt, the chatter of cultured apes, which is called civilization over there. In the poem Australia, A.D. Hope expresses his disillusionment with what is taking place in Australia. The first stanza of the poem conveys the idea that the trees in Australia are dull and it stood in a desolate place. Generally, the term nature is a charming thing, but in this continent, it looks like a desolated one. Nobody cares about it. He sees Australia as a country that is bleak and almost colorless and dull. This very much resembles the field uniform of modern wars, where everything is in shade of grey and green. Many people give importance to their outer appearance. They do not care about inner beauty. Appearances can be deceptive. The author compares the country to a sphinx. The sphinx was a figure from Egyptian myths which possessed the body of a lion and the head of a man. This comparison could be directly related to the author's vision of Australia. The poet suggests that Australia's realm of intelligence and power have been worn away, which suggests that Australia used to be better than it is now. In the second stanza, the author says that the people in Australia are heterogeneous in their tradition. People outside Australia have mistaken notions about it. They regard her as a young country, which is not. She has been emptied of all her charms. Australia may be considered young by the world's standards, but it is empty within. She has become too old to be revitalized. Her womb has dried up. That is, she cannot produce anything new. The attractions are superficial, like those of a woman who, despite her old age and loss of fertility, has still got soft breasts. He points out the vulnerability of land and the theme of rebellion. By reading this poem, the readers come to know that he is against his country. He says that there is no proper sense with respect to their culture. He adds that they are not creative and independent. In the third stanza, the poet says that Australia has nothing to boast of in the fields of music, architecture and history. She has no historical monuments. She has none of the emotions and the superstitions of younger lands. Her rivers are sucked dry by inland dry desert-like areas. He sees Australia as being a country that has neither historical background nor culture to speak of. He believes that it has the capabilities to do so. However, the ideas are drowned among inland sands. Here, Australia is portrayed as a country that is nothing at all, where there are monotonous tribes from Cairns to Perth. From the famous spot, Cairns to Perth, there is only flow of stupidity. He says that the people are stupid and foolish. The people who come to live in Australia do not boast of living, but rather merely surviving. Here in this stanza, the poet says five teeming sows which denote Melbourne, Sydney, Perth, Canberra and Adelaide. The people in these places have not had their own identity. He believes that people who move here are rather unwelcome and they are second-hand Europeans that grow rapidly on these alien shores. He sees these people as people who drain Australia. For him, it is a vast parasite robber state which has lost its original vitality. Here in this stanza, the author says that their mind is dump like the Arabian desert. The author, a lover of Australia, has come back here with the hope that some prophet will come here for the betterment of Australia. The last two stanzas refer to the modern civilization of Australia. For hope, The civilization of Australia is nothing but the false imitation of cultured apes, which is mistaken as modern civilization. He thinks that savages and sadhus wearing scarlet dress are superior to such civilized people. A.D. Hope uses imageries as a means to convey meaning to the poem. In this poem, A.D. Hope says that his country is intentionally traumatized. The poem gives a kind of negative perception regarding Australian culture. It reflects the lack of individualism and spiritual poverty. Australia is the continent with an ambiguous state. The people lost their individuality and uniqueness. They lost everything what is typically human. Hope attached the very serious problem which concerns not only here in Australia but the whole modern world. And he ends the poem with a positive note. He says that some prophet would emerge or come from the Australian ground for the betterment of Australia and the whole modern world. Thank you.